By 2020, chronic conditions like lung disease, heart disease, and cancer will account for more than 75% of deaths worldwide. Researchers in applied health sciences are working to prevent these diseases before they start, improve treatment options, and equip decision makers with new evidence to protect populations.
Each year, 6 million people die from a tobacco-related disease. My name's Dave Hammond, and I'm a tobacco control researcher in the School of Public Health and Health Systems at the University of Waterloo. I conduct research in more than 20 countries to understand what happens after countries bring in a new law. What's the best way to design a health warning? What happens to youth smoking after you ban menthol? We do everything from experiments to following smokers over time, and we give this evidence to governments so they can make the best decisions. There are more than 1 billion smokers in the world. The next generation could be the first to have a shorter life expectancy than their parents. Our work is helping people to live longer, healthier lives.
Cancer is the leading cause of death in Canada. More than 530 Canadians are diagnosed with this disease each day. For people living with cancer, finding places of support is crucial to their recovery. My name is Troy Glover, and I'm a researcher in the Department of Recreation and Leisure Studies. My research focuses on the therapeutic value of places, and in particular, I'm interested in how people who have a cancer condition connect with others in places outside their homes or workplaces. People who are dealing with cancer or who are living with cancer often are unable to talk to their family members about their conditions. They can't be honest about it. And so because of that, they need spaces where they can connect with other people who are experiencing the same thing as them. These places are crucial to that sort of support system that people living with cancer need in their lives to cope with their experience.
Osteoporotic fractures are more common than heart attack, stroke, and breast cancer combined. 1 in 3 women and 1 in 5 men over the age of 50 will suffer an osteoporotic fracture in their lifetime. My name is Laura John-Gregorio, and I'm a researcher in the Department of Kinesiology. Not all loss of muscle and bone as we age has to be inevitable. We can prevent some of it with exercise and nutrition and other interventions. And if we can prevent that, we can prevent fractures, we can prevent falls and other chronic diseases that can increase with age. My work has changed the guidance that we give to people with osteoporosis when it comes to exercise or physical activities of daily living and leisure. And we've also changed the way we educate healthcare providers, including physicians and physiotherapists and kinesiologists around managing osteoporosis with exercise.